Hello and welcome to this MAMP Pro screencast. Today I'm going to be talking about the Hosts General tab. That is the Hosts tab, and under the Hosts tab, the General section. I'm going to be using Mac OS X Mavericks and MAMP 3.05. Okay, so first I'm going to go over the left-hand section here. I have some hosts set up, and I'm going to briefly explain what all these fields are. So, obviously here is the server name. You can fill in the server name right here. And to create a new host or delete host, that's kind of hidden down here. So if I want to create a new host down here and I can just type anything in, I can do that here. And if I want to get rid of it, I can get rid of it there. So we have our server name, and next to our server name, we have this checkbox, and this checkbox is going to enable you to temporarily remove these hosts. You can start your servers, and these hosts won't be running. You won't have access to them. In the third field here, we have the PHP version. On mine, you can see I can switch between different PHP versions. If this is grayed out, that means you have your MAMP Pro set to module PHP. In module PHP, all the versions have to be set to a single version of PHP. In CGI PHP, if you have CGI PHP running, you can have individual versions of PHP on a per host basis. One other thing you'll notice is there's a default 5.5.10. and a 5.5.10. The difference being is, say you have a default version that most of your hosts want to be on. If you change the default and you have it set to default, if you change your default from 5.5.10 to say 5.5.12, all the ones set on the default will move up to that new version. If I had it this only set to 5.5.10, this wouldn't move up if I changed the default version. Hope that makes sense. Okay, extras. You'll notice here I have a WordPress host, or WP host, stands for WordPress host, and I have the little WordPress symbol here. That's because I set up this host using the extras feature and downloaded WordPress directly through MAMP Pro. If I had gone to the WordPress site, downloaded their the WordPress, which is perfectly fine, downloaded the WordPress folder, put it in, set up the host myself, you wouldn't see this little insignia here. So just in case you're wondering, hey, I set up a WordPress host, why don't I get that cool symbol? That's because you set up the WordPress yourself. And one last thing here, these hosts are being written to the user host file, and you can quickly access that here in through the interface. And that'll just, I guess, a quick review of this. It's just, I guess, showing you what's happening behind the scenes, I guess. We're writing to the host file, and you can see we always add a comment to explicitly say, yeah, this is MAMP Pro, added this line. And if I were to remove these hosts, these would go away. So we add our own comment here for the hosts that we add. And that's going to do it for the first left side of the Hosts General tab. Okay, so now I'm going to go over the right section here in the Hosts General section. First thing I want to do is quickly go back over to the left side and create a new host. I want to point something out. I'm going to create a new host, call it another host. And when I create this host, I have to pick out a document root. And I'm going to pick out this empty host 6 directory as my document root. Save the settings and restart my servers. What you're going to see here is right when you create the document root, There is a file in here, or a working website. And this working website is because MAMP Pro put in an index.php file, threw down some information here and a little art, and that's your working website. So that's just so if you, as soon as you add a host, it's going to be working. What you can do is then when you actually start doing work, remove this index.php file and then start implementing your own work. Okay, so on the right side here, we have server name, another host. If we click here, that's a great way to pull up the site. Guaranteed, it's going to fill in the correct port number, so you don't have to worry about that. If you go here and you right-click on this, you'll have this will search for all your installed browsers, so you can quickly open up the site in a particular browser. Great for checking your website cross-browser compatibility. IP address, you can let Apache choose, or you can pick the internal IP address yourself. You may have one or more choices here depending on your network connection. Port number, I'm going to go over at the end. It's a little more advanced feature. Again, you have here your PHP version. You can choose from here or here. I can choose here. That means I have module CGI. I have, CGI PHP enabled. If you click on the I button here, it's gonna open up a page with your PHP info, give you information about your current installation of PHP that's being used on this host. DIN DNS, if you have DIN DNS enabled, you can choose your DIN DNS provider here. Okay, so here in the next section, normally your name resolution is going to be coming via the hosts file, and that's how that's going to be done. We do have an option here to resolve your names via zip.io, and what I'm going to do here is restart my servers. And what this is convenient for is if you are developing or you want to check your website on your iPad or iPhone or other mobile device quickly, you can just type in this address on the browser on your iPad. Or in this case, I can check it out on my own computer, which doesn't really help. But main purpose is for checking mobile devices. You can, on your local area network, type this, as long as the other device is on the same local area network, type in this address, and you'll pull up your website on your mobile device. Or here you can conveniently just email it to yourself, and then you can pull up the email on your mobile device and click on the link, so you don't have to type in this long address. Okay, so document root, this is where you choose your document root here. You can go to your document root here. That'll allow you to quickly check some files in your Finder. Here you can choose the document root. And if you click here, you have some options on setting the directory rights. Okay, and one of the last things here on the right side is aliases. I think I set one up already for one of these hosts. Here we go. You can set up your aliases here if you want, and that's just simply if I go into my browser and use my alias. I think I have this set up, hello world. So there you can set up aliases. One last thought on the hosts general tab. I just wanted to point out this port number here, and IP address and port number. I just want to briefly go over, if you do fill these in, what you're going to see is these are going to flow to your http.conf file, which is in username library. This is a hidden folder. Username library application support absolute man pro http d.com. So this is the actual file that MAMP Pro is going to write, the real HTTP.conf file, not the template file. And as a result here of changing those settings, what you're going to get here is a few options here on your port numbers and IP addresses. And to be honest with you, that's how it flows into the file. I'm not sure of the circumstances that you would use this, but most users aren't going to need this if you're just developing locally. And that's going to do it for the screencast on the host general tab.